pairs of shoes here that we can check out, and hopefully you'll find something to your liking, or if not, you'll know what you don't like. So here we go. Let's start at the top. Okay, these shoes. This is the Bondi 5. Yeah, I do a lot of run walking for ultra running, so these ones do have a pretty significant front part here that, I don't know, it's difficult, but as you can see, the wear is back here, so that was probably some bad form that I had because these shoes were kind of clunky. Same thing. This is the Torin 2.0. This is pretty old at this point, so they may not have this particular model anymore. But as you can see, this one has a little bit of wear here from when I was walking, but most of the significant wear is up on the balls of the feet where it's supposed to be. The problem I run into with Ultras is stay that way, at least in my experience, especially when you walk in them a lot. The heel compresses and it ends up being kind of a negative drop, which a lot of people don't like, and I myself don't like, but they do have this really wide toe box that will fit the shape of your foot and allow your toes to spread out and grip the ground, or at least that's what they claim. I like to, although I found these to be clown shoes, to be honest with you. However, the newer models that I've seen aren't quite this wide, so they don't have that clunky, your foot moving back and forth like that feeling. So, I don't know. I like these, although I myself can't stand the zero drop. The zero is probably okay, but once it gets compressed in that negative, if you're doing this again, or it's even worse, is this. So, this is for a more experienced runner that is able to go fast and know what they're doing. If you're going fast enough to where you don't, your heel never touches the ground, you'll be okay. Alright, let's see. Next, we have the original Nike Freeze. Now I found these at an outlet mall up here close to my house. This is, like I say, the originals, but I think they've gone through two or three iterations. I think I bought these in 2014. I bought about six or eight pairs of them because they had a launch in my size. this one, but in this type of shoe. This, I believe, was one of the last ones I had before you couldn't find them anymore. They have, I guess they don't have the newer model, but they turn them into a more conventional shoe rather than this sock type, which I really loved. And I know my running friends like them too. The only issue I had was that sticks and acorns and stuff would get stuck in these, especially in the heel. But this is a very good choice. I recommend these for they're not a minimalist shoe, but they do have that minimalist top to them with plenty of padding in the bottom. Okay. Now, if you're going for a minimal, sandal. It's just a sandal. I've seen people run up to 100-mile ultra marathons in these. I myself am not able to run in them yet. They're pretty comfortable if you're just after a race walking. Stiff and rugged, and it's very hard to run in them on see.